Okay, YouTube, let's build a kilowatt meter, except this will be a 240, 230 volt split phase meter. So what I need is got a double gang box. Picked up this 6-in-1 universal exposed work cover for a 4-inch box. So that's this piece. It was set up with the two outlet or switch openings. What I did was open this one up as big as I could so that this guy would fit right inside of there. So this is the PZEM-061. Used a jigsaw with a metal cutting blade and a file just to open that up. So there's my meter. I've got 20 amp 220 or 250 volt plugs on all of my devices, so I'm going to put a plug in there. That way you'll be able to plug your device in here and then get a reading of the power. And then for a cord, I have these old dryer extension cords. So these are the 20 amp, 250 volt. So let me show you how we're going to wire this up. I got to do a little bit of prep work, figure out how I want to do this. Probably I've got a cable clamp. I think if I come in here with the cable, so I'm going to cut off the end of this extension cord and I'll run that in the box here, put a cable clamp on it to hold it in place, and then we'll wire up the wires to the back of the outlet. We'll run one of the wires through the current transformer, and then we'll have to run, I'll have to make two little pigtails to come off of the two hot wires. So with two 230 volt, whatever you want to call it, you've got line 1 and line 2 on opposite sides of the outlet. These outlets have no neutral connection. There's a ground, which is hooked up here, and then you have your two lines. So you've got 230 volts or 240 volts between these two pins. Now I could have purchased a European style P3 kilowatt meter, but it would have the wrong plugs on it. So I figure this way, I'll make the meter fit the plugs that I have. $3, $3, and $1, and about $6. So a little over 10 bucks to make the box. The meter, I think, runs around 15. So that's about the price of a P3 kilowatt meter. You'll pay about $30 for one of those. Okay, YouTube, I think I'm ready to put this together. I got my cord in, strain relief on there. And I've got the ends of the cable stripped. I cut off about a foot of the end, which has a receptacle that was on the end of this extension cord. And I think I'll keep that if I need to make an adapter. I've got that. I've got my outlet. I had to cut the little ears off of the receptacle because it's got to fit up inside of here. And then I also ground just a little bit off the sides to get it to fit into this GFCI opening here. Okay, I think I'm ready to put this together. One tip is put these wires in first. If you're using one of these standoff cover plates like this, you can't get into the screw terminals. You can get to the screws, but you can't get the wire in the ends. It'll clear, but the side of the case or the cover gets in the way, so got to kind of fit those in. Probably have to bend the wires down once you get them in, because you can see how tight it is in there. You're just not going to be able to easily get your wires in. So yeah, I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to cut a little notch right there. That way I can slide this side onto that screw, because I won't be able to get the screw in there. So that, I'll do that, and I'll be right back. Okay, I think I got it all wired up. It is really a tight fit. You got to get everything together. And so what I did, I have my 220 cable coming in here. So it's got the green ground in the middle, and then the line 1 and line 2. So I ran one wire over to this side and picked up the white wire on the back of the meter. I put the current transformer on this wire that's hooked to the second terminal here. So I have my white wire on the top coming down to the bottom. Then I have you can see I ran the black wire, I put the black tape on through the current transformer, and then I have the black wire here hooked to the black wire there. So I've got my white, black, and then I've got my two current transformer wires. So now we've got to get this guy down, and I should be able to split the case right there over the... Oh, looks like my green... Where did that come off of? Oh, that's my little pigtail. I forgot to hook that up to ground. So let me get that. I'll get this all stuffed together without it falling apart and show you what it looks like. Okay, one minor fix I had to do right on this top corner here. It just interferes with the little threaded tab that the screw goes in. So I used my Dremel flex shaft with the flap disc and just rounded that corner off ever so slightly until it fits. So there we go, it pops into place. So let me get this all seated in there, and then I got to try to get the screw tight on that corner. Actually, having this split actually makes it a little easier to get the meter in, because you can kind of pop the lid apart just a little bit. You have to put the meter down this way to get the wires in, and then that makes it a little bit wider, so over here it's hard to get in. So you can kind of spread the top a little bit. So let me get that popped into place, and then let's see if this thing works.